Nice guys always finish last, goes the expression, which implies awful things about Usain Bolt, but hey, he knows what he did.
You know what I'm talking. I'm a fun person. I love to have fun. Look at me.
In real life, the big, powerful assholes of this world tend not to get punished all too much. Money talks, power walks, and Charlie chalks. It's depressing.
Got you clean, huh? What's the matter, honey? Little extra cheese on the taco?
Thank goodness, therefore, for the movies, where Johnny B. Goodguy tends to emerge on top, except when he doesn't, and then, oh god, the cycle of sadness begins all over again. I'm Adam from WhatCulture.com, and here are 8 awesome movies where the bad guy wins. Spoilers, obviously. Number 8, The Terrorists Win. Arlington Road is a film from that period of American history post-Oklahoma City bombings where the word terrorist was most commonly associated with an unhinged white male, not the narrative in today's media.
Terror. Terrorists, instruments of terror.
In the film, said unhinged white male is Tim Robbins, aka Andy Dufresne, except he's actually guilty and has little time for Rita Hayworth. He lives next door to protagonist Jeff Bridges, and in the film, Robbins' character's turn-ons include blowing up FBI buildings, looking shifty, and Joan Cusack, the monster. At the end of the film, not only does his plan to blow up a government building succeed, but he receives zero comeuppance, bumping off the hero, making an orphan of his kid, and retiring to a nice peaceful life with Joan Cusack. If such a thing exists. Number 7, Bond loses. It's not often that Jimmy Bond, Her Majesty's favourite tailored sexual predator, comes out ultimately losing in his quest to drink an Oliver Reed worth of booze and blow up a town, but that's what happens in On Her Majesty's Secret Service, the red-haired stepchild of the Bond franchise. It's often unfairly maligned for its odd one-out status, with Lazenby's supermodel Bond at odds with the Connery that came before it.
This one's different.
But it's surprisingly great on a rewatch. Give it a try. It's certainly got the most affecting ending of all the films. Bond settles down and actually gets married to Diana Riggs Tracy.
I love you.
They're all loved up and happy when Blofeld and a henchman drive by and gun down his bride before escaping scot-free. Oh. I mean, sure, Bond foiled Blofeld's grand scheme, but the one who lost the most by credit's end was Bond, James Bond.
It's Blofeld.
Number 6, Don't Trust a Murderer. The original The Vanishing is often overlooked in the pantheon of great thrillers, partly because the original film is Dutch, and partly because the English remake starring Kiefer Sutherland is fairly balls terrible. It's an examination of morality and the banality of evil, stay with me now, and is about a man called Rex, whose lover Saskia is kidnapped by a man called Raymond. Which we can all agree is the creepiest first name in existence, except maybe Gilbert. The ending is shockingly bleak, with Rex driven to distraction over what happened to Saskia. Raymond offers him a cup of coffee to drink because that's the only way that he will ever find out the truth. Rex drinks it and wakes up in a coffin, buried alive, while Raymond lives out the rest of his days happy with his family. What? Number 5, Big Bad Court, Bigger Bad Loose. Silence of the Lambs was great, made a megastar of Anthony Hopkins, and launched a near insufferable stream of parodies involving people wearing masks and doing this. The less good sequels, Red Dragon was alright, have lessened the sting in recent years, but the ending of Lambs is really unsettling. Sure, Clarice guns down Buffalo Bill, putting an end to his unique skinwear business before it really got off the ground. However, the more dangerous and calculating villain, Hannibal Lecter, escapes, and the last shot is of him, off scot-free, and about to have his foe Dr. Chilton for dinner. Number 4, Ed Norton Isn't Crazy. Well, Ed Norton's a bit crazy. I mean, look, he's the epitome of strung out white dude who brings a gun to the office.
You're in a hell, and you're gonna die in a hell like the rest.
Come on now.
In Primal Fear, his bad guy status is confirmed. Throughout the film, while on trial for murder, Richard Gere's sympathetic lawyer discovers that Ed Norton suffers from multiple personality disorder, his dark alter ego Roy being the actual killer. Eventually, Roy manifests himself, and Ed Norton is found not guilty by reason of insanity, whereafter, in a shocking twist, he reveals that there never was any Roy, that he made the whole thing up, and that he's not insane after all. He's just a casually sociopathic killer all along, but not insane. I don't know. Either way, Ed Norton is a bad boy. Number 3, Envy's a Killer. 7's great, despite the fact it's got a number in its title. It wasn't fine when Tuck3n did it, or when Fant4stick did it, and it's not fine here. But still, great movie. So 7n follows Brad Pitt and Morgan Freeman as they try to track down a killer, murdering people via the 7n Deadly Sins. It ends with the killer caught, his masterpiece unfinished, wrath and envy left unclaimed. Until, what's in the box? What's in the box? What's up with that?
You piece of...
Turns out Pepper Potts' head is in the box and Pitt has the choice. Succumb to wrath and murder the killer for his envy, completing the masterpiece, or walk away. He chooses the former, and even in death, John Doe wins. It's really great.
Have you ever seen anything like this? No.
Number 2, The Greatest Trick the Devil Ever Pulled. Speaking of great Kevin Spacey moments, when your twist ending is so secret that even your lead actor thinks he's the killer until he sees the movie, you know you're onto a winner. Yep, Gabriel Byrne actually thought he was Kaiser Soze right up until The Usual Suspects came out.
This whole thing was a shake then.
But hey, even if he was, that wouldn't change the fact that Soze emerges on top. Verbal Kint spins a tale of the boogeyman out of lies and coffee cups, then leaves, his limp slowly transforming into a swagger as it's revealed that he was the Kaiser all along. Kaiser Soze, I mean, not the Kaiser like the German Emperor Wilhelm II. You get it. And number 1, The Last Laugh. The Joker is one of the greatest villains of all time, an avatar of chaos, a permanent and terrible reminder of the fragility of both life and sanity. One of his overarching goals is to convince Batsy and the world that there's not much difference between sanity and insanity, that most people are just one bad day away from losing their minds, or as Ledger's Joker puts it, madness is like gravity. All it takes is a little push. He takes a hero and turns him into another costumed freak. Now, he may be winding up back at Arkham in the end of the film, but the last shot is of the Joker swinging in the air, plan complete, laughing, laughing, laughing. And that's our list. Did we miss any out? Tell us about it in the comments. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. You can even follow me on Twitter here. I'm Adam from WhatCulture.com, and I'll see you soon.